What's up, guys? I told you guys I was gonna do a nice little soapbox tonight, and I figured I'd go ahead and do it, regardless of how tired I was. First, I just wanna say thank you before I even get started on this soapbox thing, because I'm like putting the little live button thing on, and then it pops up on my face, and I'm like, oh my goodness, I look like holy hell. I literally have not been able to wear any makeup because I feel like it's gonna mess with my eyes, or it's gonna do something to my eyes that I can't jeopardize my eyes going bad or whatever. Me and Julie are gonna talk about that when I see her Friday, so she can make me so pretty again, because I feel so, yeah, we won't talk about that. But anyways, what's up, Jessica? Hi, Jesse. What up, Jay, Angela, Javier? All right. So I'm gonna give you guys a little insight before I jump into like why I'm actually doing this particular soapbox. So usually my videos that I do, it has some sort of meaning behind it. Sometimes it has absolutely zero meaning behind it whatsoever. And I'm just complaining about something or bitching about something because it's just, you know, I'm good at that. You know, I'm just good at telling the truth and unfortunately being incredibly blunt and very, very black and white. Sometimes it sucks. Sometimes it's good. But hey, you know, in my situation, it really doesn't matter. But so as I was growing up, you know, my younger days, let's call it whatever it is, you know, when you don't have much to lose, you do stupid shit. Okay. Now, when I say you do stupid shit, like something goes down, let's just say something you didn't like, whether it was with your boyfriend. What's up, Denise? Hi. Something with your boyfriend, something at a club, something, maybe it was at school, whatever. Maybe it was at a bus stop. I don't know. Maybe it was at a traffic light or something, right? I had an incredibly short temper, okay? And when I met John, he was like my yin to yang, okay? John, you don't want to see John angry because that's never a good thing. It's an ugly, 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 ugly scene. It's like a murder scene, okay? But I am the mean one, let's just call it that, and John is the nice one, right? So we make such a great team because we even each other out so well. Now, with that being said, you know, everybody's done stupid things in their life, right? I mean, every single person on this entire thread, Denise, Wayne, Mark, Justin, all you guys, every single one of you guys on here, Tina, all you guys have done something stupid, right? Well, as you get older and you have kids or you have a business or you have something to lose or you have more to lose, you start thinking about how you want to handle things. So it's like, okay, instead of me going down the street and beating the hell out of somebody because they did something they probably shouldn't have done. Now, this is back in the day. No cameras on every corner. It wasn't like that back in the day. Some of you guys know back in the day, it was like a free-for-all, right? Literally a free-for-all. Like, you know, hey, meet me by the bleachers and then we'll just duke it out and everything will be cool after that. Like either we're going to be friends after we duke it out or we're just going to duke it out and we'll say, all right, you won this, I won that, and we're done. That's how I grew up anyway. I don't know how all the rest of you guys grew up, but this is like legitimately truth. I'm only speaking the truth, okay? What up, Big Rodzilla? What up, Steph? So anyways, I've learned to do things that I have to do it the right way nowadays. And a lot of times that takes a lot of patience. And I am a very impatient individual as well. At least I can admit these things, okay? So nobody can get on here and punish me for admitting that I am impatient and that I can have a short temper sometimes, but I have been able to control these emotions over the years. And you know, John has been a great Yoda and I've been his little Padawan and he has taught me how to control these very anger emotions, or whether I was upset or whatever, taught me how to condense it into a little ball and how to control it. What up, Ryan? How are you? Hi, Jerome. Hi, Elizabeth. I guess I had my peoples. Anyways, so we've come to certain things that, you know, you got to handle certain situations. You know that song by Biggie, like More Money, More Problems, like that song is real. It's like not just like the best song on the planet, like ever, but it's like very real. You know, the more successful you are, the more issues you run into, the more problems you have, the more heat that you have on you and more eyes you have on you. And that's just what it is. It's just how it is. You know, I told you guys already, people that know who I am and they follow me and they know a little bit about me, people that know me know that I didn't grow up with money. I didn't come from a family with money. Like, and every little dollar, all the way down to like a Gatorade or a replacement remote, I have had to pay for, you know, with like literally my first job was at 14. Okay. So anyways, where I'm going with this entire conversation, that was me. I got suspended from school. Yeah. I mean, Denise, girl, let me not tell you. I've been suspended a couple times, and at least I can admit it. I'm not going to sit here. I mean, this would suck, right? Wouldn't it suck if somebody got on here and they're like, I'm an angel and this is what I do. And I am an owner of a company and I've been perfect my whole life. Never, ever missed a day of school, straight A's forever and ever. And everything's always been perfect. No, it's never been that way. I'm not perfect. Never admit will be to be perfect. Okay. And you know, shit happens. Everybody's done stupid shit. I've done stupid shit, you know, and you learn from your stupid shit. I would hope you learn from stupid shit. So anyways, you know, me and John have been through this very, very, very long journey of, you know, being in business. And when you go in business, you know, you have to protect your business. You have to protect the people that are in your business. You have to protect your family. You have to protect your funds. Okay. You also have to protect your intellectual property. Now, you know, when it comes down to things like this, I just want to ask you guys a quick question. Okay. Let me ask you a question of how this rolls. Okay. Cause I mean, I'm not going to tell you guys like what went down this week. It's like some people know, some people don't. And I'm going to leave it like that. But when you're going this, like say you're on a highway, right? Now me, I drive fast. That's just how it is. I've driven fast since I was 15 with a permit, driving on a little permit all by myself. Shouldn't have been in the car with no adult, driving around town, having a good old time, okay? Now, when the speed limit is 60, okay? And you're going 70, because I mean, you really can go 10 over the speed limit and not get in trouble. Let's be real. State troopers, cops, Jerome, come on. You know how that goes. But when you start going in a speed limit zone of 60, and let's just say you start going, I don't know, let's just throw a number out there. Let's say you go 93, okay? Let's say you're going 93 to 95. What do you expect when the cop pulls you over for going 95 in a 60 mile per hour speed limit zone? What do you expect is going to happen? Why do you think that people, like, you know, why do you think that they put laws in place? Do they put laws in place so people don't follow them? Do they put laws or contracts or, you know, do they stipulations? Do they put these things in place so that nobody follows them? No, they put them in place for either safety reasons, protection reasons, or financial reasons. I mean, there could be a bazillion reasons I could sit here and say this is why, you know, the state of Florida or the state of New York or Cali or wherever the hell you live, you know, has put these stipulations in place so that you don't do these certain things that can hurt people. Okay. So say you're going, you're in a 60, you're going, let's just say you're going 100. Okay. It's one thing when you get pulled over, you get a speeding ticket and you're going 75 in a 60. Shit. I just got a speeding ticket. You kind of deserved your speeding ticket. You already knew it was coming. Don't fight with the officer. You knew you were speeding. Okay, if I ever get pulled over for speeding and they ask me, ma'am, do you know what I'm pulling you over for? I'm like, well, hell yeah, I do. I was speeding. I'm trying to get to work. I'm doing 100 things at one time. I'm very sorry, officer. Please give me my ticket so I can leave. I know. I'm very straightforward. Like I told you, black and white. I don't know any other way. This is just how I was built. Okay. So anyways, let's just say you're going 95. Okay. I don't know if they're going to give you a ticket. I don't know. I think they might drag your ass out of your car and probably cuff you and probably put you in some cuffs and tell you that you're doing reckless driving and possibly suspend your license. So here's where I'm going with this is that there's rules and stipulations that are put in place for certain reasons so that people follow the rules. Okay. And the reason why people are supposed to follow the rules is so that other people don't get hurt or for whatever reason. I mean, there's a bazillion reasons, guys. Some of you guys out there are in banking. Some of you guys are in accounting. Some of you guys are in videography. I mean, think about videography. When you're doing a video, do you have somebody sign off on a model release form? Absolutely. Why do you do that? You want to protect your video. When you want to pump it out, and let's just say that person that's in your video, let's say you guys don't get along a year later for whatever reason that might be, now you're not able to put that video out because they didn't sign model release. It's little things like that. So if you're not going to abide by certain things, whether it's a model release, a contract, whatever it is with a company, don't sign it. Don't sign it, because there is a reason that the companies, corporate companies, small business companies, mom and pop shops, I don't care what kind of company it is, but there's a reason they put these things in place. I'm not quite sure. I mean, some people, I guess they put it in place just as a scare tactic, like, hey, if you don't work here anymore, we're going to come after you. But the truth is that they're putting that in place because it's probably going to be enforced. So if you don't think that you're going to be able to handle that, do not sign it. Okay? That's number one. So, yep, without rules, laws, society would have... You are right on the money. You're right on the money with that. What up, baby Emmy? Hi, Jen. You're right on the money. If we didn't have any rules and we didn't have any laws, everybody do whatever the hell they want. I mean, think about it right now, guys. All right? Let's just think about, and this is no offense to anybody under the age of 23 on this feed, okay? But back in the day, we were a little bit more free for all, okay? Could you only imagine if we had access to be able to do half the shit that these people do nowadays? Like if we had Facebook and videos and all these other like accessories, we would be able to bury people back in the day. It wasn't like, hey, it was a he say, she say, this went down kind of thing. It doesn't go like that. So, you know, at the end of the day, guys, you know, I've come a long way in my life where I've had to learn that there are rules that need to be followed. And there are laws that have been put in place to be followed. And if you do not follow these rules and these laws and these stipulations or whatever it might be, you can get in trouble. That's what happens. You can get in trouble. They don't just put these things out there for no reason. Come on, guys. You guys have got to agree with me on this, you know? That's why I use the speeding thing as an example, because I think we all speed, right? But I think that there's some of us that go 10 miles over the hour or miles per hour. And then we have some of us that want to be reckless and you're going to go 35 miles over the miles per hour. And then God forbid you hit somebody, then they're dead. Okay. So like I said, I've come a long way in my journey of learning. Okay. I've had to come across some serious learning curves and had to learn some things the hard way, which I don't want Peter to learn the hard way. So I always try to tell him, you know, listen, this is why this is this way. This is why this is that way. But I do, in this video, I want to give some props to a couple different. I'm going to start with, because I am religious. I'm Catholic. Well, now, you know, Greek Orthodox, let's say. But I am, you know, I am a big believer in God. And I do believe that if you do the right thing and you do the right thing by people, that the right thing will come back to you, like karma. Okay. Karma could be good and karma can also be bad, right? But I do think, I truly believe that if you do the right thing, that you will have the right thing come back to you, even if it doesn't seem like it in that moment. And let me tell you, I can't even count on my fingers and toes, 3 or 4, maybe 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 times around, how many times in the past like year, 2, 3 years where I'm like, you know, I don't know if I want to like abide by the law. I just want to go do this. I don't think this is right. This is not cool. I have, you know, whether it's a situation where somebody's taking advantage of the situation, taking advantage of me, taking advantage of my family, taking advantage of my business, taking advantage of my husband, you know, maybe saying some things that shouldn't be said, maybe saying things that are not true, that kind of stuff. Just, you know, we've been through a lot. You know, when you're successful, you're under the hot lamp and it is what it is. I've accepted it. But guys, just know, you know, like I really truly believe this and I'm gonna like give it to you guys like this. And I want you to know this. I will share it because I am not that person that you met, you know, 10 years ago when you met me, it was me for me, okay? So if it didn't benefit me directly or how was it gonna help me, I didn't care. That's just how it was though. I mean, I wanna say probably about 15 years ago. that's how I was. I mean, I was like that. And Peter's not going to be like that. But, you know, I always tell Peter the truth. I'm not going to lie to Peter. Like, this is how your mom was, you know? It was ride or die. And it was me for me. And whatever was going to help me directly. And then, you know, I met John. And John's like, it's not, you are not to live your life like that. Like, you can't. So, of course, you know, I turn things around. And I'm a lot nicer. And I'm a lot more open to people. And I'm able to let people in a little bit more than I was at that time. And, you know, I feel as though we got to a point where there's got to be some happy medium of who we let in, who we don't let in, and that kind of stuff. Because, you know, it's serious, guys. You know, things get kind of serious. So, I mean, through my trials and tribulations of what I've been through in my lifetime and all the suspensions I've had for doing stupid things, okay? Or, you know, whatever else, nightclubs and all the fun things of, you know, my flirtatious, wonderful ladies, John's buddies that need to be thrown out of the club by me personally. We won't talk about that either. Hi, Julie. I miss you. Fix my lashes. But I'm being totally honest with you guys. I'm never, ever, ever going to fake it to make it. This is who I am. But I am a better person today. And I do truly believe in karma. I do truly believe in God, and I do believe that if you are a good person and you do the right things, I do believe that that will come back to you. Now, will that come back to you in 2 hours? I don't know. Will it come back to you in 2 days? I don't know. Will it come back to you in 2 months? I don't know. Will it come back to you in 2 years? I don't know. But it will come back. I promise. It will come back. So one day I'll get on this soapbox thing. I'll prepare you guys for it. And maybe one day I'll tell you guys like some of the trials and tribulations that I've actually been through that none of you guys know. Maybe one or two of you guys out there in my entire life know. But some of the trials and tribulations I've been through that has made me the person I am today. But I am grateful that I have learned patience over a period of time. And I have learned to be an adult, because that's really what it is. It's all about growing up and being an adult and following the rules and the laws. Because if we didn't have any, everybody would be just, what's that movie called where they, you know, like at midnight, they shut down the thing and they all, yeah. So it'd be like Purge, you know? So they just shut down and we just go kill everybody that we hate and, you know, that piss us off at some point in time in the year. And then now we all purge and everybody's good, right? Just kidding. So our, yes, John, yes, we are nice too. We are just a little too nice sometimes. Okay. That's where I step in and I'm like, okay, hold up, slow it down. Niceness is going a little too far now and, got to still, you know, back it down. Also never fake. No, I'm never fake. Jules, you know that. I love you. It's a boomerang effect, 100%. And Julie, I can't wait to see you fix my face. I know you say I look pretty, but you don't understand. I'm so used to like my lashes being so voluptuous. And it's looking a little scattered. So anyways, I just wanted to jump on here and kind of share some stuff with you. Me and John have been through some things this week. I am all about being professional and all about, you know, making sure that we do the right thing. And we have done the right thing for a very, very long time. And I just want to say that it's been a long journey and I'm happy with some of the outcomes of this week. And I can only do this is I can only be good in the future, do the best that I can to help people and make sure that we continue to do right by people, regardless of how many people do us wrong, okay? Because I am the first person, because I'm not the nicest person you've ever met. I know I look really nice, okay? But I am not the nicest person you've ever met. And, you know, John has really helped me through on being a good person. Like, just generally speaking, just being a good person. You know, like, even if somebody does something bad to you, to not necessarily null and void it, but jot it down and, you know, learn from it. Peter wants to say something.
To you too, Mom.
Please don't say anything crazy.
I have an early Mother's Day present.
Oh my God, this weekend's Mother's Day, guys.
in early.
I'm a mother.
I couldn't wait to show you because I was so proud of my work that I did today.
Yeah.
Me in the middle, like animation.
Oh my god, how cute!
And since you guys wanted it regular.
Can I show you guys? Look at Peter's drawing. Aww, it's us. This is what makes it all so adorbs. I love it so much. Let me just.
I tried to draw you into a dress, but then yeah. I totally forgot.
You should totally make sure I'm wearing leggings and like a V-neck next time. I'm kidding. Anyways, guys, I just wanted to share. Isn't he cute? I mean, seriously. I love it, and I can't wait to take it to work and put it on my desk. I'll rip it out so it doesn't get ripped for real.
I will.
So anyways, guys, what up, Neek? And Nicole, Chenille, Julie, they all said that they love your picture and they think it's super adorable. Thanks. So anyways, guys, I had to share this with you because, you know, we've had some big things take place. And, you know, it's really, really, really.
Good night.
I love you, baby. Go take your medicine too, please. It's taken a lot out of me to be the professional that I am today. Do I curse? Do I say shit? Do I say bitch? Do I say all these wonderful, fun words all the time? Absolutely. It's just, I don't know. It's just who I am. I can't help it. And it's, you know, it is what it is. But have I built myself into a better person than I was 10 years ago and have more patience and learn to try my very best to abide by as many rules as possible and try to do the right thing, not just by the rules and the books, but try to do the right thing by people. And sometimes it backfires on us and sometimes it doesn't. But the times that it does backfire on us, I just try to sit there for a second and think and say, okay, maybe there's a reason behind this. Maybe there's, you know, maybe there's something down the line. Maybe we're helping them in some way, shape, form, aspect. I don't know. You know, like I said, one day I'll get on here and I'll tell you guys some of the things that I've been through. And when I tell you guys some of the things that I've been through, you'll be like, wow, that's why that girl is why she is the way she is today. And yeah, no, not because I'm crazy. I am crazy. But not because I'm crazy. But what does not kill you will make you stronger, and that is a fact. Okay, so I did want to hop on here. If you're ever in a position where you feel like you're upset about something, or you want to do something to somebody or a individual or a company or whatever it is, that because you're angry about something, just think things through. Just try to think it through. That's number one. Number two, people come up with contracts, guys. Read your contracts before you sign it. There's a reason there's contracts. The contracts are there so they're enforced. They're not there so that people go sue happy. They're there so that they're enforced, okay? If somebody's presenting you with a contract, there's a reason they're presenting you with the contract. Don't just sign the contract. Read it. It's important to read it. Read every page of it, all right? So I wanted to hop on here and share our mini soapbox with you guys and kind of just tell you like my life lessons of this week, because, you know, to wait 4 years, 4 or 5 years to go through some things for 4 or 5 years to finally get some sort of closure this week, takes a lot of patience, and it takes a lot of patience, and it can be emotionally, mentally, and physically draining. And I mean, you have to keep on going. You know, you still got to get up. You got to take care of your kid. Got to take your kid to school. Got to make sure your kid's doing good in school. Got to make sure your business is going good. You got to make sure the girls in the office, since there's a whole bunch of them and they all have a bunch of estrogen, aren't going to rip their faces off because they're all PMSing at the same time because they're all aligned and they're PMSing now. You have to make sure that everything's going good with all the patients, that everybody's happy, all their packages are on time, nobody's having any symptoms, everybody's up to date on all their checkups. It is a lot. It's a lot. I don't complain a lot. You won't hear me complain a lot. I'd rather have more to do than not have enough to do, even though that sounds absolutely absurd. But I'm telling you guys, okay? So if you're ever in a position where you feel as though you should probably beat the shit out of somebody, just take a second and take a deep breath. Okay, Nicole, take a deep breath and just think about what the repercussions of that could be. Just want to know. Just take a second, because sometimes you don't think. So I know that back in the day, I didn't used to think. Mm-mm. There was no thinking process. There was a, oh my God, I'm pissed off. And then, oh my goodness, here we go. There was no like in-between process. My mom used to be really, really mad about that. I inherited my dad's genes. My dad had some serious genes going on, okay? My mom, she's the more laid back, cool, chill individual. My dad, a little bit more aggressive type individual. I think I got that kind of blood flowing through these veins right here. But if you learn to control it, you can actually use it to your benefit. So I want you guys to take a second, because I know that there's some of you guys out there. I know there is. There's got to be some of you guys out there that, you know, you might run into a situation where you're on the road with somebody and they cut you off. And I mean, listen, I'd be the first person to want to take something and throw it out the window and crack their window with it. I know that sounds horrible, but should you do that? No, you should not do that. Okay. Are you going to get in trouble if you crack their window and then they get your license plate number? Probably. Okay. So just think about shit before you do it. That's all I'm saying. And what goes around comes around. It's story of life. What goes around comes around, baby. So just always think about what you're going to do before you do it. As my mother would say, think about what you're going to say before you say it. Boy, do I suck at that. But I wanted to come on here and jump on here, give you guys a little insight. It's been a very, very great, amazing week for us. Not just, you know, personally and at home. Peter had his FSA testing. I think he did absolutely amazing because my son rocks math. But I did want to share some of this with you guys. And hopefully I have been able to give some insight to some of you guys that have short fuses or have short tempers, or maybe sometimes you may not say it out loud, but you know deep down inside that maybe you should have thought that through a couple more times before you made that decision. Or maybe you should have thought that through a couple more times before you decided to act on it. Or maybe you thought that through a couple more times before you decided to say something. So just think about it. Just think about the video, okay? There's rules, there's laws. Follow them to the best of your ability, you know, across the board, no matter what field you're in, whether it's medical or whatever. And I will leave you with that note. And my eyes are better. I just can't seem to manage to put in these drops every 2 or 3 hours or whatever it is, when I can't even manage to have like lunch or like drink water. So let's just see how these dry corneas work out for me. Should be fun. But anyways, guys, Elise, I hope I get to see you soon. And text me, because you're a slacker, 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 slacker. And let's get together soon. For the rest of you guys, hopefully I will be in some sort of mood on my next live, that maybe I'll even do my eyebrows and I'll have my lashes done and a little bit of makeup, so I'm not looking like holy hell, okay? But anyways, guys, I'll leave you on that tip. Think before you speak. Think before you do. There's always rules in place. There's always contracts in place for a reason. They didn't make it up for no reason. We're running into 2020 and it's only going to get stricter. So just remember that. Okay. Anyways, I love you guys. I'm sending my love from myself, from Titan Medical Center and our Titan Medical internal team. Nicole, I love you. You're my baby boo-boo, boo-de-boo-boo. And I will talk to you guys soon. And I'm going to go get some sleep because I'm exhausted. Probably watch the Pauly D, whatever, dating show or something like that. I don't know, something stupid that I don't have to think about. So that way I could just look at it, and I'm sure that something on there is going to make me laugh and I don't have to actually process it. I know. You guys actually get to know the real me on here. I don't filter very much of it, which, hey, wouldn't you rather get to know the real me than me be fake and be like, oh my God, this is me, but it's really not. No. So, anyways, I love you, Nene. I'll see you tomorrow. You're my favorite nurse practitioner on the planet. And I couldn't do it without our team. And I ever so love my husband because I wouldn't be the person I am today without him. To be quite honest with you, I might even be in jail if I wasn't for him. Possibly. Mm-hmm. Yep, short temper. Running about this much space. Anyways, so thank you, John, for making me into the I am today.